Good morning everyone. In our previous class, we have seen about first and second Anglo-Mysore Wars in second unit from trade to territory. I already taught you these wars were majorly fought in the South Indian regions, right? Yes. In this session, you are going to know about third and fourth Anglo-Mysore Wars. It was happened between 1790 to 1799, isn't it? Yes, in this topic I added few information for your understanding. That's not in your textbook, so listen carefully. Before I start today's topic, let's we see the answer for homework question. The question is, what were the causes for the first Anglo-Mysore War? The first reason is Hyder Ali developed as one of the most powerful kingdom in Mysore. And the second reason is Hyder Ali's friendly relationship with the French. These two reasons were led to the first Anglo-Mysore War. Yes, let's we move to the today's topic, third and fourth Anglo-Mysore War. In this part, first you have to know few things about Tipu Sultan. He was, which means the Tipu Sultan was born on 1753 near Mysore. And he was also called Tiger of Mysore. Durg Fort in Nilgiris is the famous fort of Tipu Sultan. Fort of Durg was the famous fort of Tipu Sultan. And Tipu Sultan was the ruler of the kingdom of Mysore and a pioneer of rocket artillery. What is it? Rocket artillery. And he opposed British rule in South India. Then he played an important role in keeping the British forces away. Isn't it? Yes. Shortly, the third Anglo-Mysore War was fought between 1792. Isn't it? Yes. The battlefield was Travancore and it came to end with the Treaty of Srirangapatnam on 8th March 1792. See, the causes of the third Anglo-Mysore War was caused by an attack on Travancore by Tipu Sultan because he had differences with the Raja of Travancore in 1789. Because of that, the English declared war against Tipu, supporting the ruler of Travancore. Then they were held by the Marathas and Nizam's troops under the English army, which was led by Cornwallis and marched towards Srirangapatnam in 1792. Then another reason is Tipu sent his ambassador to France and Turkey for getting alliance of foreign powers against English. France and Turkey for getting alliance of foreign powers against English. Isn't it? Yes. The cause of the battle is the Tipu fought alone against the British. And the war was continued for 2 years. The third Anglo-Mysore War was fought in 3 parts. First, the British general Medu attacked the Mysore. But he was failed. Because of that, Cornwallis led the army in 1790. Against the Tipu Sultan. Then Cornwallis captured all the forts which was abstracted to reach Srirangapatnam. Then Tipu offered tough resistance but eventually signed the Treaty of Srirangapatnam in March 1792. It was resulting in the surrender of nearly half of the Mysore territory to the victory's team, which means the victory's allies in the third Anglo-Mysore War. Tipu also had to pay 3.6 crore for war reparation amount. Of over 3.6 crores. Then the British hens occupied the areas of Gurg, Malabar, Dindukal and Paramahal. See, here the Marathas and Nizam also occupied some places. First, the Marathas gained a few places on the river Tungabhadra side. Then the Nizam occupied some territories from river Krishna to beyond the river Pennar. The last war in this series is 4th Anglo-Mysore War, happened in 1799. The 4th Anglo-Mysore War in the conflict in South India between the Kingdom of Mysore against the British East India Company and the Hyderabad Deccan in 1798 to 1799. Isn't it 1798 to 1799? I already told you the battlefield was South India and the battle happened in 1799. 4th Anglo-Mysore War happened in 1799. Actually, Tipu didn't forget the humiliating imposed by Cornwallis. So he thought to associate with foreign powers. For that, he sent his ambassador to other countries like Arabia, Turkey, Afghanistan and French. Then Tipu Sultan became a part of Jacobin Club. It was started by French officers who came to Srirangapatnam. Then they planted Tree of Liberty. See, before 1792, Jacobin Club was called the Society of the Friends of the Constitution. Later it became, which means after 1792, it was renamed Society of the Jacobins. It was commonly known as Jacobin Club. After that, it became the most influential political club during the French Revolution period. Then the Jacobin government was made such greatest social reform like the abolition of slavery in the French colonies. Whatever, let me turn to the topic. At this time, Lord Wellesley was the Governor General of British. He was demanded to Tipu Sultan give up his friendship with the French. But Tipu refused that. Because of that, Lord Wellesley declared war against Tipu in 1799. Isn't it? Yes. See, one side Bombay army attacked west direction of Mysore by Commander Stewart. Another side, Madras army attacked Tipu Sultan by Arthur Wellesley. Arthur Wellesley was the brother of Governor General at that time. Can you remember who was the Governor General during the 4th Anglo-Mysore War? Lord Wellesley. Yes, you are right. Lord Wellesley. Arthur Wellesley was the brother of Lord Wellesley. So here, without another way, Tipu Sultan retreated to his capital. What is the capital of Tipu Sultan? Srirangapatna. It is located near the city of Mysore. Yes. But the British captured the island fortress at Srirangapatna on 4th day of May 1799. Isn't it? And Tipu Sultan was killed in the battle. At the end of this war, the whole Mysore came under the hands of the British. See, the consequence of this war was the whole Mysore came under the hands of the British. Especially, the British occupied Kanara, Vayanad, Coimbatore, Tarabaram and Srirangapatnam. Isn't it? Again, Third Krishna Raja Udayar of Hindu aristocracy ascended the Mysore throne. First, the British restored the Udayas to their throne by way of subsidiary alliance. Then again, the third Krishna Raja Udayar, he was a Hindu aristocracy, ascended the Mysore throne. Then the Udayas continued to rule the state until in 1947. Until 1947, during the period of 1799 to 1947, Mysore developed as one of the important centers of art and culture in India. Even today, they were continue to influence on rocket science, music, and art. Okay, yes. After the death of Tipu Sultan, his family, including his sons, daughters, wife, and his mother, was sent to Vellore Fort. After 1806, Sipahi mutiny, the British transferred Tipu's son and daughter, Tipu's sons and daughters, exiled to Calcutta. Do you know one more thing, children? After the Cholas, our district also ruled by the Karur Nayakas and Tipu Sultan. In 1793, the British destroyed the fort of Karur and captured the place. And one more thing, a memorial built to those who died in the war with the British in 1793 is at Rainur in Karur district. Isn't it? Okay, students, with this topic, come to the end of this session. In our next class, we can see about Anglo-Maratha Wars. I hope you are clear with today's session. If you have any doubt in this part, just go through the whole session once again. And still some of them didn't complete your classwork, social classwork. So try to complete within 2 days in separate notebook, which you are maintaining for social science. Okay, thank you.